Hello students, today we meet again for another new chapter, and in this unit today we'll be learning about the Harappan culture and Indus Valley civilization. So now let us look into the contents of this particular unit. We'll be learning about the discovery and location of the Indus Valley civilization, the town planning, administration, craft and technology, thread, Harappan script and seals, agriculture, religion, and the decline of Indus Valley civilization. So now, let's proceed with the class without further delay. The discovery and location. Firstly, in 1826, an East India Company soldier and explorer in India, Charles Mason, came across some mysterious brick mounds in Punjab and thought they looked like old castles. 30 years later, in 1856, railway engineers found such brick which lay railway tracks, but they did not realize its significance yet. It was later in 1921, an Indian archaeologist, Daya Ram Saini, understood the importance of the site and excavated the ruins of Harappa on the banks of River Ravi in western Punjab. In 1919 to 1920, Rakhal Das Banerjee, an officer of the Archaeological Survey of India, came upon the remains of another ancient city in Mohenjo-daro under the supervision of John Marshall. In 1931, large-scale excavations were carried out at Mohenjo-daro under John Marshall. Likewise, similar ancient cities were unearthed from locations in the Indus River Valley. These ancient cities were part of the Indus Valley civilization, which flourished between 3000 BCE to 1800 BCE. The Indus Valley civilization is also known as the Harappan civilization because Harappa was the first site of the civilization to be discovered. Most sites of Indus Valley civilization are on the banks of River Indus and its tributaries. Moving on to another topic, that is the town planning. Now let us see what do we have under this. Firstly, we have the citadel and lower town. Many cities were divided into two main parts, the fortress and the lower town. The fortress was usually located to the west on a high ground above the rest of the city. Archaeologists have identified it as a citadel or the acropolis, meaning some high fortified area. Big brick platforms formed the foundation of the buildings in the citadel. This was done to protect the buildings from flood because of its location on the river banks. This citadel contained important public buildings like the granaries and the worship areas. Below the citadel lay the lower town. Historians believe that the ruling class occupied the citadel, whereas the lower town was occupied by the common people. Next, we have the street. The streets were laid down in straight lines, cutting each other at right angles and dividing the city into different blocks. Next, we have the houses. Houses were built of mud bricks. They were single-story or double-story. Each house had a central courtyard and rooms opening into it. Thick walls kept the room cool during summer. Dust and noise were kept out, as windows never opened into the main street. Side windows let in light and air. There were wells bathing places, and drains in most of the houses. The drainage. The drains were made of kiln, fired or baked bricks and were usually covered. They had a slight slant so that the water could easily flow. These drains were connected to the main drain in the street. Another very important town planning was the Great Bath at Mohenjo-daro. Archaeologists have unearthed a huge public tank in the citadel mound called as the Great Bath. The floor of the tank was made of burnt bricks. The tank has 6 entrances and central bathing area. There were stairs on both ends along with side rooms. A wall was also discovered in the adjacent rooms. One of the corners has an outlet connected to a drain. The Great Bath was probably used for religious rituals and ceremonies. Next we have the granaries. Granaries were found both in Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. They were probably used for storing surplus grains. The granaries were located around the river banks and there were rows of circular brick platforms meant for threshing grains. At Harappa, archaeological remains point to the presence of factories of metal workers and potters next to the granaries. The remains of furnaces indicate that the metal workers used to produce objects of copper, bronze, tin, and lead. Next we have administration. There is not much certainty about the nature of administration, but the remarkable town planning which we have seen in the earlier part of the video also tells us how Indus Valley civilization had a very efficient administrative system. There was probably some kind of administrative authority which took care of agriculture, production of items and labor in order to ensure food for the entire city and for a smooth process of trade and organization and to build a successful city life. Next, we have the craft and technology. The Harappan cities were centers for production of craft which were traded with distant lands. They used bronze extensively due to numerous bronze goods. It proved existence of group of artisans, that is bronzesmith, in the Harappan society. The bronzesmiths manufactured not only utensils but also tools and weapons. Bead making was practiced and weaving, knitting crafts flourished. The art of lapidary, which means engraving, cutting, and polishing of stones and gems, was thus very popular with the Harappans. The Harappans were skilled potters. The pots usually had designs in black color and had design of plants, birds, and animals, which were often painted on a red surface. Trade. The Harappans exchanged goods through barter system. In exchange for finished goods, they probably acquired metals and food grains from neighboring villages. Harappans traded with the Mesopotamian civilization. Harappan script. The Harappan script is pictographic, which means that the script is in the form of pictures, in which each letter stands for some idea or object. Writing was done with a sharp tool or pointed stick of soft clay to scratch marks on stone or metal. Harappan seals. Thousands of seals have been found from the Indus Valley sites. Most of them have short inscriptions with pictures of one-horned rhinoceros, god, elephants, buffaloes, and crocodiles. The seals were probably used for stamping by people in authority. Some seals were also used as ornaments by people, which is very popularly known as amulets. Agriculture. Agriculture was an important occupation of the Harappans. They were farmers who lived in villages which were near floodplains. Archaeologists have found remains of rice, mustard, and sesame. They domesticated animals, and farmers produced enough to feed not only the inhabitants of the villages, but also to feed the people of the towns. The grains were then stored in different granaries. Religion. Religion was not the basis of social bonding during the Indus Valley civilization. However, female figurines have been found and was probably worshipped by the Harappans. The bust of bearded man was found in Mohenjo-daro in 1927. Historians are of the opinion that the bust either represents a king or a priest. The historians also assume that the Indus Valley civilization people probably practiced nature worship. The decline of Indus Valley civilization. The Indus Valley civilization declined between 1900 and 1700 BCE. The mounds got piled up, drains were blocked, people stopped building their homes. There are various theories as to why the Indus Valley civilization came to an end. Now, let us have a look at all of these different theories, one by one. Some believe that the river changed its course, which caused drought in some areas and flood in some other areas. There are some who also believe that the deforestation was one of the major causes of the decline of Indus Valley civilization. Whatever the factor, it must have led to an environmental disaster which caused the crops to fail. People starved and diseases spread. Skeletons showed that people died from malaria. However, there are no evidences of war or mass killings. Now, whatever the different theories may be, Indus Valley civilization came to an end, unfortunately. With this, we come to an end for this particular unit. I hope you have learned something new. Thank you for watching, and remember to stay safe.